Hello friends and welcome to this devotion. We've been going through a series of devotions from last Sunday morning's sermon by Michelle entitled Rebuke the Wind and Speak to the Waves. Today we're going to dwell on the idea that we'll have to speak out in faith to some of the storms that rage against us. We've been looking at this concept of Jesus rebuking the wind and then speaking to the waves to be still. And this is not the only time that Jesus called for us to speak to inanimate objects. Jesus cursed a fig tree. Fig trees usually don't answer back, but this one shriveled at his command. Jesus said to us that you can speak to a mountain and tell it to be moved, and if you believe, it will move. There is definitely something for us to be saying in order for us to release our faith and to cooperate with faith in the natural realm. Even God spoke creation into being, and this ability to command creation is innate to us because we've been made in his image, the image of the God whose word called everything into being. Jody Hughes says, our words awaken divine purpose and evict the enemy's interference in whatever circumstances we aim our faith at. I like that. Jesus' word of rebuke evicted the enemy's interference and calmed the storm that would have been destructive to him and his disciples. So my question to you is, what words is Jesus giving you to speak to the enemy's interference in your life? Because surely the enemy would love to interfere with you. His words in your mouth, his words in my mouth, spoken out in faith, have power to move mountains, transform our circumstances, transform our times, and change our nation even. We can take either God's breathed word to us, that is those whispers of his spirit, the prophetic words he may have given you, the things that he's vocalized to you, and we can speak those out in faith, or we can take his written word and speak his written word out into the circumstances. Whichever you prefer, go to it. Find a word that he has given you or a scripture that is especially meaningful to you at this time. Confess that. Speak it out into your circumstances. Ascribe greatness to God out loud. Defy your circumstances with the truth about Jesus. Dare to declare the promises that Jesus has made to you. See, we can be those who speak to the unseen with spirit-given words in order to see the kingdom of God manifest in the realm that we can see. Who is this, they asked, that even the winds and the waves obey him? Even creation, even inanimate objects must obey. And your faith-filled voice has the same potential. So speak to the winds that oppose you. Command them to be still. Speak out the promises of God. Speak out deliberate blessings over those you love. Release peace by your words, the richness of God onto people's lives, and watch what God will do in your circumstances. I know it sounds crazy, speaking to your mountain, but it's something that you and I are going to have to get used to if we want to see our mountains move. The alternative is to go round the mountain or take the long road to climb over them. We can strain at the oars of the boat, trying desperately to bail the flooding waters out of the bottom of the boat, or we can rebuke the winds that are causing the storm that are threatening us. Try this at home, when no one else is with you but the Lord. Submit yourself to God by deliberate action and prayer, and then rebuke the wind and speak to the waves buffeting your life. Just tell them, peace, be still, be quiet in Jesus' name. Creation still bows its head to the King and his words that he speaks through you. We miss you. Think of you all the time. Pray for you every day. So looking forward to being back together again as a people. God bless.